Being naturally suspicious of the prince, Little John decided to keep a close eye on him. So he invited himself right up to the royal reviewing stand.
Ah, me lord. My esteemed royal sovereign of the realm. The head man himself. You're beautiful.
He has style, his. Du savoir faire, il y a, n'est-ce pas?
You took the words right out of my mouth, PJ.
PJ, I like that. Do you know I do? Hiss, put it on my luggage. PJ, ha ha, ha ha, ha
And you? Who might you be, sir?
I am Sir Reginald, Duke of Chutney. And don't stick your tongue out at me, kid. And now, Your Mightiness, allow me to lay some protocol on you.
Forgive me, but I lose more jewels that way than... Please, sit down.
Thanks, PJ. Couldn't get a better seat than this, could you? The Royal Box. Oh, hey, wait a minute, what's... Excuse me, Buster.
Buster? You, sir, have taken my seat.
Hiss with you around. Who needs a court jester?
Now get out there and keep your snake eyes open for you know who.
You mean I'm being dismissed?
You heard his mightiness. Move it, creepy. Get lost. Be gone, long one.
What cheek? Creepy. Buster. Long one. Who's that dopey duke think he is?
All the archers in the tournament paraded before the royal box, and each in turn paid his respects to Maid Marian, including Robin in his strange stork disguise, which didn't fool Marian a bit.
Ah, your ladyship. Begging your pardon, but it's a great honor to be shooting for the favor of a lovely lady like yourself. I hope I win the kiss.
Oh. Well, thank you, my thin-legged archer. I wish you luck. With all my heart.
Your Highness, with your royal permission, we are ready to begin.
Proceed, Captain.
The Tournament of the Golden Arrow will now begin.
I'm sure I don't have to tell you who won the tournament. It was Robin in a breeze. But when he confronted the prince to claim his reward, he got a little surprise.
Archer, I commend you. And because of your superior skill, you shall get what is coming to you. Our royal congratulations.
Oh, thank you kindly, Your Highness. Meeting you face to face, Your High and Mighty, is a real treat.
Release the royal fingers. Ah. And now I name you the winner. Or, more appropriately, the loser. Seize him. I sentence you to sudden, instant, and even immediate death.
Oh, no. Oh. Please. Please, sire. I beg of you to spare his life. Please, have mercy.
My dear emotional lady, why should I?
Because I love him, Your Highness.
Love him? And does this prisoner return your love?
Marian, my darling, I love you more than life itself.
Ah, young love, your pleas have not fallen upon a heart of stone. But traitors to the crown must die!
Traitor to the crown? That crown belongs to King Richard. Long live King Richard!
Long live King Richard!
Enough! I am king! 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 Off with his head!
When Little John saw the dirty work afoot, he slipped around to the back of the royal box and applied a sharp knife to the princely back.
Executioner, stop! Hold your axe.
Okay, Big Shot. Now tell him to untie my buddy or I'll...
Sheriff, release my buddy! I mean, release the prisoner!
Untie the prisoner?
You have what he said, bushel britches!
Sheriff, I make the rules! And since I am the head man... Not so hard, you mean thing. Let him go, for heaven's sakes! Let him go!
Love conquers all!
Well, not quite. Or not quite yet. You see, the Sheriff of Nottingham discovered Little John's knife caper, and then the battle was really on. It was a Brannigan, a Donnybrook, a real boisterous set, too. And everybody was into it. Even Lady Cluck, who got in some very powerful licks on some of the biggest of the prince's rhino soldiers. While the battle royal was still going on, and Little John and the Merry Men were having a lot of fun in the roughhouse, Robin Hood and Maid Marian slipped away off through beautiful Sherwood Forest.
It seems like only yesterday you were just a child at play. Now you're all grown up inside of me. Oh, how fast those moments flee. Once we watched a lazy world go by, now the days seem to fly. Life is brief, but when it's gone, love goes on and on.
Their stroll was a leisurely and lovely one, and by the time they reached Sherwood Forest, all the gang from the battle were there, exhausted but exuberant.
Long live Robin Hood!
Hooray!
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 And long live Maid Marian!
Bravo! Bravo!
Here, here! Bravo! Bravo! Hooray!
And down with that scurvy Prince John!
Yeah! The world will sing of an English king 1,000 years from now, and not because he passed some laws or had that lofty brow. While bonny good King Richard leads the great crusade he's on, we'll all have to slave away for that good-for-nothing John. Incredible as he is inept, whenever the history books are kept, they'll call him the phony King of England. A little tycoon's rather like a puppet on a string. And he throws an angry tantrum if he cannot have his way. And then he calls for Mom while he's sucking his thumb. You see, he doesn't want to play. Too late to be known as John the First. He's sure to be known as John the Worst. A pox on that phony King of England. Lay that country on me, babe.
Thank you.
while he taxes us to pieces and he robs us of our bread. King Richard's crown keeps slipping down around that pointed head. Ah, but while there is a merry man in Robin's wily pack, we'll find a way to make him pay and steal our money back. A minute before he knows we're there, old Rob'll snatch his underwear. The breezy and uneasy king of England, the snivelling, grovelling, measly, weasly, blabbering, jabbering, gibbering, jabbering, plundering, plotting, wheeling, dealing, Prince John, that phony king of England.
Little John's song became a big hit with all the people of Nottingham. Even that unlikely songbird, the sheriff, found himself singing it as he and Sir Hiss counted the day's tax collection in the castle hall.
John the worst!
The fabulous, marvelous, merciful,
chivalrous... Oh, you got it all wrong, Hiss. The sniveling, groveling, weaselly, measelly...
Enough!
But, sire, it's a big hit. The whole village is singing it.
Oh, they are they? Well, they'll be singing a different tune. Double the taxes. Triple the taxes. Squeeze every last drop out of those insolent musical peasants.
Well, Prince John wasn't exactly what you'd call a good loser. Unable to capture Robin Hood, he took his vengeance out on his poor subjects, and they paid dearly. Believe me, taxes, 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 taxes. Why, he taxes the heart and soul out of the poor people of Nottingham. You know, if you couldn't pay your taxes, you went to jail. Yep, I'm in here too. Nottingham's in deep trouble, believe me.
Every town has its ups and downs. Some towns' ups outnumber the downs, but not in Nottingham. I'm inclined to believe if we were so down, we'd up and leave. We'd up and fly if we had wings for flying. Can't you see the tears we're crying? Can't there be some happiness for me? Not in Nottingham.
Since practically everyone was in jail, there wasn't very good attendance at Friar Tuck's church.
Friar Tuck? I don't think anyone is coming.
You're right, Sexton, but maybe the sound of this church bell will bring those poor people some comfort. We must do what we can to keep their hopes alive.
Oh, how can there be any hope of that tyrant Prince John taxing the heart and soul out of the poor people?
Yes, those poor people. Look, our poor box is like our church. Empty.
Friar Tuck, we've saved this. It's not much, but it's take it for the poor.
Your last farthing? Oh, little sister. No one can give more than that. Bless you both.
Oh, we were just saving it for a rainy day.
Well, it's raining now. Things can't get worse.
Howdy, Friar. Well, it looks like I dropped by just in time.
What is that big-bellied bully want here?
Father, shh.
Oh, well, what have we got here?
Now, just a minute, Sheriff. That's the poor box.
It sure is. And I'll just take it for poor Prince John. Every little bit helps.
Oh, you put that back.
And His Majesty also blesses you, little sister.
You thieving scoundrel!
Now take it easy, Friar. I'm just doing my duty.
Collecting taxes for that arrogant, greedy, ruthless, no good Prince John?
Listen, Friar, you're mighty preachy, and you gonna preach your neck right into a hangman's noose.
Get out of my church!
Ow! Ooh. Ow! Ooh. Ow! Ow!
Oh, dear me.
You want taxes? I'll give you taxes.
Give it to him! Give it to him! Give it to him, Friar!
You're under arrest for high treason to the crown.
It was just about the last straw when the sheriff of Nottingham put Friar Tuck in jail with the rest of the people of Nottingham. And it got worse when Robin Hood learned of Prince John's evil plan to stage a hanging of Friar Tuck in order to lure Robin Hood to his rescue and thus capture Robin. Robin decided the night before the hanging that he and Little John would try to sneak into the jail and let all the people out while Robin stole as much of Prince John's money as the people could carry. So Robin Hood and Little John silently slipped into the courtyard of the king's castle, where they found the sheriff of Nottingham sleeping away in front of the door of the jail, while his two crazy aides, Nutsy and Trigger, the vultures, did sentry duty. Robin and Little John hid behind the wall, and when Nutsy made his way toward them, he was tapped on the head and yanked over the wall. Quick as a fox, Robin donned Nutsy's uniform and popped back into the sentry area. Trigger sensed that something was strange. Something strange was going on, and he was kind of nervous about it.
Sheriff, everything ain't all's well. I got a feeling in my bones there's gonna be a jailbreak any minute.
Criminally, Trigger, point that pea shooter the other way.
Don't you worry none, Sheriff. The safety's on old Betsy here.
Oh, look out! What in tarnation you trying to do, you bird brain?
Just doing my duty, Sheriff.
Oh, you and that itchy Trigger finger of yours.
Hey, did you hear that?
Sure did, Trigger. There's something funny going on around here. Come on. You cover me. Wait a minute. Is the safety on old Betsy?
You bet it is, Sheriff.
That's what I'm afraid of. You go first. All right, you in there. Come out with your hands up.
Yeah, reach for the sky.
Just you watch this pre-foreman's partner.
Be careful, Rob.
Jehoshaphat, Trigger, put that pea shooter down. Oh, shucks, Trigger, it's only Nutsy. And criminally, get back to your patrol. On the double, get!
I'm a-gettin'.
That Trigger, he's getting everybody edgy. Nothing's gonna happen. That fat friar is gonna dangle from the gallows come daybreak.
Sheriff, why don't you just sit yourself down here, kind of cozy-like?
Well, thank you, Nutsy.
Just close your sleepy little eyeballs. Mm-hmm. The Sandman's a-coming. Mm-hmm. Why don't you, let me loosen that belt? Rock-a-bye, Sheriff. Just you relax.
Relax. Oh, Nutsy, that's mighty sweet. Sing it one more time, will you?
Rock-a-bye, Sheriff. Just you relax.
I'm relaxing.
Dumb. Ba-dum, bum, 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 ba-dum, bum. Do, 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 do.
Once the sheriff was asleep, Robin took his keys and gave them to Little John and said, "Now release Friar Tuck and the others, and I'll drop in on the royal treasury." Prince John was so worried about his money that he kept most of it in little bags of gold coins in his bedroom in the top tower. Robin scaled the tower and, shooting an arrow with a rope over the door of the jail, set up a pulley and began tying the bags of gold onto the rope and reeling them over to the jail where all the good folk gathered them in. Unfortunately, Prince John awakened just as Robin was taking the last bag of gold. He rushed to the window and screamed for his guards, only to see that all the villagers were running out of the castle carrying his gold. Robin Hood was left behind, and he was besieged by the prince's soldiers. "After him," yelled the prince. "Kill him! Exterminate him!" It looked very bad for Robin as he climbed higher and higher up the castle walls with the soldiers in pursuit. Then suddenly the castle caught fire, and Robin was trapped in the top corner with flames all around him. There was nothing to do but jump, and jump he did, a long, long way down into the moat. Prince John and Sir Hiss watched him dive, and when he didn't return to the surface of the water, shouted with glee that Robin was done for. Even Little John and the villagers thought Robin had drowned. Cleverly using a straw to get air, Robin swam underwater down the moat until he could climb out and rejoin his friends safe and sound.
You know, I thought we'd never get rid of those two rascals. But lucky for us folks, King Richard returned and, well, he just straightened everything out. Say, we better get over to the church. Sounds like somebody's getting hitched.
As the bridal couple rode off in their beautiful chariot, they went past a rock yard in the jail where Prince John and Sir Hiss were busily breaking rocks. As the bridal party approached, Nutsy said, "Here comes the bride, Trigger. Present arms." And when Trigger did, his arrow went off again and zipped through Sir Hiss's sweater and almost hit Prince John before finally coming to light in the just married sign on the back of the wedding coach. So Robin Hood and Maid Marian waved farewell to their friends, and they all lived happily ever after.
Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly, golly, what a day. Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly, golly.